Before the video starts, I figured that I should show you the intro of the original video we're commentating on today.
Something amazing has happened. Strange men have come to our shore. They are not like us. Their skin shines like the sun, and some of them have hair made of gold. Their sticks make thunder like the gods. And they have huge beasts that fly upon the sea.
Yup, we are dealing with those types of people. Gotta love the subtle SS imagery being presented. And to add insult to injury, if you didn't notice or you're not in the know, they're actually using Nazi-era military music playing in the background. They even changed the pitch to conceal it. Search up music from Rommel's Africa Corp, and if you find it you might see some similarities.
Strange men have come to our shore. They are not like us. Their skin shines like the sun, and some of them have hair made of gold.
We're off to a great start, aren't we? Well, hello there everyone, the Eurasian Steppe here, and welcome to another shitty commentary that will single-handedly turn the Amazon rainforest into a fucking savanna. Today we will be taking a look at a video entitled, How Multiculturalism and Diversity Destroyed the Native American Indians, uploaded by a user by the name of Truthmonger, and created by a person that goes by the name WhiteRabbitRadio, who also created such classics such as Anti-Racist Hitler, among other wonderful works. God damn it, I think I should give everyone that talk about what we are dealing with here. If you've been deep enough into the right-wing political sphere long enough, chances are you've heard of this conspiracy theory known as white genocide, also known as the Great Replacement. Basically, it's this idea that white people are being purposefully being demographically replaced by brown people through mass migration, all being perpetrated by what seems to be Jews. Now, mass migration in Europe has its own problems all in its own, but obviously the whole idea of the European fertility rate being purposefully destroyed is complete bullshit, and the people falling for this nonsense are only helping to further a political agenda by crypto-Nazis. Also, I forgot to mention that the video that you're about to watch was originally uploaded by WhiteRabbitRadio himself back in 2012, so this is way before the mass migration in Europe and Donald Trump becoming president, and this can prove that the Great Replacement lie has all been propagated from the start, and these alt-right people only grown in popularity since these things took place. It's almost like they were only waiting for it to happen. Anyway, let us begin being enlightened by the ideas the video has to offer. How Tolerance, Diversity, and Multiculturalism Destroyed the Native North American Indians by Regressive Liberalism, a film by the White Rabbit. Firstly, the Native Americans were already culturally diverse from the start, ranging from various tribes like the Cherokee, the Navajo, the Shawnee, the Iroquois, the Lakota, etc. Often they were at war with each other and formed alliances because of how different they were, same thing with many European countries. Take for example, Germany. Germany started from a bunch of tribes, then it became a collection of states within the Holy Roman Empire thanks to the Franks' invasion of that area, and now the Germany, as we see today, is one unified country, and many Germans can be traced back to many diverse German tribes or kingdoms south of where Germanic culture started, as well as areas in modern-day France, as many of them migrated to East Francia some time ago. I myself have ancestors that can be traced back to Central and Northern Europe, and it can be argued that, because I was born in Bavaria, and that I was raised Catholic, I might have some Northern Italian or even Southern Slavic admixture. I mean, to be honest, I don't look like the most Aryan person in the world in real life. So, Germany, or, if we were to look more broadly, Europe in general, is pretty damn culturally diverse, and they are preservant of their own cultures despite those admixtures taking place long ago. But, that's not what the video is about, is it? It has less to do with multiculturalism, but multiracialism. Look, many nations in Europe has been preserving their culture even after many types of admixture for a very long time, and to think that a few million brown people are going to make a difference seems a little ridiculous. Yes, we've had terrorist attacks perpetrated by people claiming to be refugees, but that can be solved if we actually had agencies that can prevent it, which is something, mind you, Germany has the power to do.
What? Hello?
Holy hell, this shit is too funny. I mean, why are their mouths moving like that? Their mouths are moving all over the place.
What? Hello? What are you doing here?
Beg pardon, but are they seriously using actual Native Americans to voice the natives? I mean, not using voice actors pretending to sound like Native Americans, just using actual Native Americans to voice them. It sounds too authentic for it not to be the case. If that's true, then that's pretty fucking cool.
What are we doing here? We came to settle down and live. Why?
Live? Are you going to live here?
Yeah, why do you ask?
Well, it would look like you pale-skinned folk don't seem to bear any survival techniques, mind, if we show you how to grow corn for the winter.
Are all of you going to live here?
Yeah, you got a problem with that?
And all of a sudden George Washington's audio input rises in volume for no reason. Thank you, video.
Well, this is our land. You can't take our land.
Excuse me, your land?
Yes, our people's land. It belongs to us.
He's right. The Patuxent tribe has been settling in what is today Plymouth, Massachusetts for thousands of years.
We Indians have lived here for thousands of years.
Precisely what I said. Wait, did you say Indians?
Indians? What's that?
Hold up. Weren't the Europeans the ones calling the Native Americans Indians? Damn, the plague that the Spanish brought into the New World has devastated the natives so much that the tribes settled their differences and amalgamated into a pan-national identity at the seams.
We are Indians.
There is no such thing as an Indian. We're all humans. Oh geez, I didn't know that such ignorant bigots like you were still around.
I still can't get over the horrendous lip-syncing. It's almost like the animator just drew a bunch of frames with different mouth movements and haphazardly mushed them together hoping for the best result. If there is a reasonable justification for using tweens in Flash instead, it's to prevent it from looking like this.
You really need to be educated.
Even though the pilgrims come from uneducated backgrounds, so... Wait, if these are pilgrims, why aren't they wearing the traditional type of pilgrim clothing, as opposed to the 18th century clothing that they're wearing? It's like the video doesn't even know where it's supposed to take place, and the amount of confusion was so severe that it was shot in a parallel universe where pilgrims wore clothing from the future. Alright, I am pretty sure you guys by now caught the gist of the video. The creator of the video used Native Americans and pilgrims to illustrate a conspiracy theory that white Europeans are being demographically replaced by brown people. This is perhaps one of the most hilariously ridiculous parts of the video, the idea that white people will suffer the same levels of extinction as the Native Americans did, even though one of the main players of how the Native American population dwindled the way it did was through diseases like smallpox, and in some cases it was intentional. Whites were the ones carrying the disease, and Native Americans for the most part had no immunity to it whatsoever, so the idea that we will suffer the same way the natives did seems retarded. Europe was able to kill off 80% of an entire race. What would brown people have to take to wipe us out? Bombings? A few beige babies? Unlike the native tribes, Europeans and Americans have borders. Even the places you deem as lib-cut places have borders, and we are also in the middle of a pandemic, and not even the worst virus we're facing right now is a threat to the white race.
This land belongs to our people.
Our land is your land, and your land is my land. We live in a globalized world now, don't you know?
Globalization, the process by which businesses or other organizations develop international influence or start operating on an international scale. Yeah, I can totally imagine something like that taking place in 1612. The Pope at the time was working with other nations to stop the usage of fossil fuels.
I can't believe you don't know that. It's 1612, for heaven's sakes. Are you still living in the 1530s or something?
We Indians came here before you. You can't take the land from us.
Are you racist? There are no lands for certain people. The earth is for everybody.
I don't think natives believed in the concept of borders or the owning of land. or at least the ones in the present day United States or Canada. I could be wrong.
We're all humans. Indian is just a social construct.
Now I kind of agree where the creator is coming from with this. Native Americans is not just some social construct. Same thing goes with Europeans, Africans, Asians, and Pacific Islanders. The reason is that they lived in the American continent before anyone else.
Yes, we might all be humans, but it's still our land. You white men can't steal it from us. You have no right to do it.
You are imagining things in your racist little mind. We are not taking anything from you. What's wrong if some of us live here in America? Don't you know we all have a common African ancestor?
Wait, the Pilgrims were Puritan, right? Naturalistic and evolutionary thoughts like the common African ancestor would be considered sacrilege, and they probably wouldn't acquire that type of information given the social positions they are in. Besides, evolution wasn't even common knowledge at that time, Darwin wasn't even born at that time, so the house of cards are already falling on this one. And, watch this. The European immigrants are using modern-day liberal, cultural Marxist terms to justify their demands for open borders. This is also the exact same technique Muslims are using to dominate Western societies. Yeah, I can totally see Muslims' mind view, using information that contradicts their religious beliefs anyway, assuming they acquired that type of knowledge at all given the social positions they're in. Epic fail.
It doesn't matter. You white men are not like us. We are Indians. And this is still our homeland.
You racist Indians are thinking too much in terms of us and them. You should just accept diversity. And if you do, diversity will be our greatest strength.
I mean, I think diversity can be a strength to an extent. Reasonable amount of immigration, for instance, can have a positive impact in the native culture, as the native population can find a way to make use of it. If Africa were to open the doors to Japanese or Chinese people, and assuming they brought their culture with them and respected local laws, you might see stores opening selling plushies with American and Japanese texts on them. Just a little thought experiment that many politards can play with, as I assume they are the most susceptible to bullshit like this. I can understand that, if you don't want to get your culture destroyed, but realistically it's not going to happen anytime soon, if at all.
Can't you even see with your own eyes that we look different? How hard can that be?
Oh God, there is only one race, the human race. What on earth are you afraid of? Why would it be such a problem if we white people live here with you?
Well, for one, you have some sort of disease that had already killed our tribes, so...
The only problem here is your racism toward us.
You will destroy our culture and our way of life.
Define Indian culture, please.
What?
You just claimed that there was an Indian culture, so now I demand that you define exactly what that Indian culture is.
Well, Indian culture, or Native American culture, can be defined as culture that originated from the Amerindian people. From the tribes of North America, the tribes of the Amazon rainforest, the Mesoamerican civilization, the Incas, among other places in the American continent, if we wanted to properly identify Native American culture, we would then have to amalgamate them into one behemoth and call it a day. It would make sense, because Native Americans have been living in isolation for thousands of years with very little influence from the outside world, aside from maybe the Vikings in Canada. However, Europe is a little different from that. Europe is a continent close to Africa, the Middle East and Asia, so there might be some sort of influence from them, and vice versa. Both the Romans and Ottomans may have something to do with it.
Okay. We eat corn in our village, and we have ceremonies when we dance around fire and a pole called the totem pole.
I think that is common in the Pacific Northwest, and not say Massachusetts, where the Pilgrims came.
Well, in Europe we have these white Swedish people who eat Falun sausages and dance around a maypole every summer. We're not that different, you see. And what threat is it to your culture anyway, if we live here?
You know, if you recall the core message of the video, the natives are supposed to be the white people and the white people are supposed to be the brown hoarders trying to infiltrate Western civilization. You know, if you truly wanted to convince leftists that they should protect their own race, you're supposed to make us agree with the Native Americans and have them make more sense than the person with the man bun. The goal of the video is to seemingly make us accept the idea of an ethno-state, but if you fail to come off as more rational than the critical theory Lipschitz, why should I believe that you have any good reason for having it in the first place?
If you come here and dominate with your culture, it will change our way of life too.
No, no, no. If you're so scared of that your precious little culture will be destroyed by us, let me assure you, you can dance around your pathetic totem pole all you want.
Why is he so mean? I mean, the guy with the ponytail came off as more rational until he started insulting the way of life of the Native Americans. What gives?
Look here. If you white people come with this amount of ships every day like this, say 500 ships a day with 300 people aboard for 80 years, you'll eventually be a majority in our land.
Firstly, this is only the first onslaught in European colonization of the area, and there is no way of telling if there are going to be more people coming. Second, how do you even know if there are 300 people in each of the 500 ships? What if they only carried less than even that? Thirdly, I don't think the math adds up correctly. Okay, as established before, 300 people times 500 ships would be 150,000 people every day settling the area, right? If I multiply that number to 365 days, not counting the ones in the leap years, that would give me 54,750,000 people settling in a year. If we multiply it by 80, which is something that the Indian mathematician said would be the year when they become the majority, that would give me 4,380,000,000, assuming that none of the people settling during that time died from either natural causes or killed by another tribe during battle. That sounds like a lot of people for 17th century standards, considering that only 500 million humans lived during that time.
Whites will take over America? Ha 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 ha! That is just a racist Indian neo-Nazi conspiracy theory.
Wait, what? Neo-Nazis? The National Socialist German Workers' Party wasn't even around at that time, so why in earth would they be Nazis, let alone neo-Nazis?
No, it's not. You will be majority in our land in the future if present trends continue.
And that's what they are, present trends. Who knows, maybe things might change in the future. Not saying the demographic trends changed in real life for obvious reasons, I am saying that the refugee crisis going on in Europe might cease and many of the refugees will go home and rebuild their domestic countries, so it's not always the smartest thing to rely on present trends to predict the outcome of the future. Same thing with the fertility crisis in Japan. No, Japan's fertility crisis will not lead to an extinction of the Japanese people in the year 3000, you frivolous weenies. This demographic situation is only one moment in a period of time, and maybe we will see some new results if they eventually fix some of their problems they are facing that led to it. Present trends aren't always permanent.
Even if we whites take over America, who cares? It's just skin color. You should not be making an issue out of skin color. After all, it is the person inside that really matters. We all bleed red.
It does matter.
How so? Why does it matter if the people who are coming over to Europe and the United States happen to be not white? I mean, unless, if they are causing problems in the parent country, I don't think there is that much to worry about. Besides, the white European babies are being made every day more than that of the migrants, since they take up the majority of the continent, so it is unlikely for them to overtake us if they tried.
America would become a little lighter in the future. Why would you make such a big fuss out of that?
Because unlike the refugees coming to Europe and America, the white people coming to Native America were carrying a disease that made it easier for them to take over. This is why it is nearly impossible to take over a continent inhabited by the same people who carried the disease.
It's not just skin color. We have different skull shapes. And a lot of other things that are different.
I think the writer of this video is trying to pinpoint us to IQ.
Now you are starting to sound like a Nazi. We are 99.9% genetically the same according to scientific studies.
What studies? There was very little study conducted pinpointing the difference between different humans back in the 1600s. It was mostly stuff relating to Christianity and God, and how the world came from to humans, but whatever.
There is only a tiny little genetic difference between us. Really tiny. And like I said, even if we whites do take over America, you're a smart Indian mathematician here. Recently just told everyone that it won't happen for another 80 years.
Yeah, over 4 billion Europeans, even though the population of Europe was around 78 million at that time, will live on the American continent, every single one of them, sometime in 1692. It doesn't just take an average IQ person to figure out that something's not right here.
And you will all be dead by then anyways. Why waste precious little time caring about the future?
Can we all get a round of applause for the brain-damaged Native American in the back, as well as the clones that are standing right along the chief?
You won't even be alive then. Enjoy your life. It's too short to go around full of hate. By 1715, we whites will have integrated into this society, and we'll all be Indians just like you.
It doesn't matter if you integrate into our culture. You are not one of us.
Just because we are white, we are not allowed to be Indians? That is so racist.
Well, not only wouldn't you be Indians, you wouldn't be the actual Indians in the Indian subcontinent. Oh, and by the way, didn't some of the colonists actually escape from their colonies to join the Native American tribes? I could be wrong.
Why did you shoot him?
Well, didn't you see that? That was a Nazi who wants to kill 6 million Jews.
Oh, I see. Good shot, Lord Nelson. One Nazi down.
What?
I got a feeling here that it might be a lot of Nazis in hiding. I got that impression just by this conversation with that Indian chief. He kept using the terms us and them. Can you believe that he has a problem with us just because we are different?
I mean, to be fair, I could kind of understand, given that European colonists have been slaughtering and subjugating native populations for the past 100 years now, which is something that white nationalists seem to be proud of. Gee, for people who ask why brown people are taking you over, you seem to love taking over and subjugating other nations for your benefit.
These racist attitudes make me ill.
Yes, I think your observation is spot on, sir.
You see, we all bleed red. So what's the big deal if you share this land with us?
Holy shit, animation.
Well, I think there will be a conflict if you live here with us. We will not be able to live happy with each other side by side.
Man, a natural point that I can somewhat agree with. I can admit that immigration can somewhat have some consequences in the social sphere. If you live in an all-white town or civilization back in that time period, that skin color is going to be ingrained into your head, and you're going to associate it with people you know. If new people with different skin colors come along and start taking over, you might feel a sense of isolation and a lack of a sense of belonging, which is not something a healthy person should experience. Even then, this is back when multiracialism was at a bare minimum. Nowadays we seem to mostly associate many social characteristics with things like class, religion, language, nationality, etc., as a means of social isolation if one group takes over another. It is a survival mechanism, and it is nothing that can be eradicated overnight.
In your little ignorant racist mind, perhaps, but I believe in humanity. One humanity. Why can't we all just get along?
Exactly.
Because you are different.
An immigrant is just a friend you don't know.
That only depends on what type of migrant it is.
I hope they believed it.
So, according to the video, none of the immigrants that come to America or Europe are your friends. Ouch. You know, just a food for thought, America has been suspicious of immigration since the foundation of the country. From the Irish, the French, the Russians, the Scandinavians, the Chinese, the Japanese, the Jews, the Mexicans, and, get a load of this, the Germans. Yes, Germans, people were actually suspicious of German people coming into the country. Keep in mind that this is pretty much what many white nationalists view of what a true Aryan should be. But, as time went by, these immigrants integrated into America, and even added some parts of their culture to intertwine with America's already diverse melting pot.
When we whites settle down and get a job and pay taxes, we will become Indians just like you.
Okay then, but at least can't we get a little peace for ourselves in our homeland so we can preserve our people?
Why do you think you have the right to your homeland in the first place?
Why not? I mean, preserving your own people or whatever doesn't seem that irrational. If you want to preserve your domestic culture, fine. But it's always important to adapt in some way so you can become more relevant in the long run.
Are Indians a superior race or something?
No, I'm not saying that we are superior. But
besides, what's the big deal if your precious Indian race gets mixed away in a sea of white? It's called evolution.
Again, evolution, as a concept, didn't exist at that time, so what the fuck?
You sound like an Indian supremacist to me, talking about your land and the preservation of your Indian people and culture.
No, I'm just saying that...
Why won't you share your rich continent with us poor immigrants who have fled from religious persecution in Europe?
Never mind the fact that in the original video, the public was cheering as explorers sailed off to the New World, so I don't see how this is comparable to actual refugees who don't want to live under a caliphate.
We are just seeking a better life here. Why do you hate so much? What do you have against this little white girl that has traveled here all the way from Europe? What do you have against her?
Maybe the source picture of the drawing is probably a woman and not a girl. or that the side of her face melted off during the voyage. By the way, aren't the white supremacists supposed to be the ones showing pictures of little girls with the braids, and not the liberals who want people to immigrate to America? Just a thought.
I have nothing against that little girl. I don't know her.
Exactly. But it is these individuals we are talking about here that you want to throw back into the sea, sending back to be persecuted in Europe.
I'm serious. She looks older than she should. It looks like a woman was used as a source picture. I'm not trying to be creepy. That's literally what she looks like. I mean, look at the size of her nose. Usually we would see kids at that age have smaller, puffy-looking noses, but no.
What an inhuman thing to do. Look into her eyes. Why do you want to harm this little girl?
Because kids are fucking nasty. They are ugly pieces of shit and all they do is shit all over the place and vomit all over the carpet. They always have to have snot hanging from their fucking noses and eye discharge rolling down from their eyes. They scream and cry all the time and they are generally annoying and disgusting creatures and they deserve the frying pan in whichever way you perceive the outcome, whether it be hitting them with or cooking them and eating them so you wouldn't have to deal with their bullshit ever again. I'll explain it to the police.
I have nothing against her, but...
But what? It's hard to see racism when you're an Indian.
The reason people say that it's hard to see racism when you're white is that many Americans, specifically European Americans, take up the majority of people in the US, and because of that, many of them are unfamiliar with the struggles many minorities have to go through when it comes to socioeconomic reasons. It's not entirely their fault, many of them are unfamiliar with it, but it is still important to recognize them if we want to help them in any way.
I had enough of this. You whites cannot come over here and take our land. I don't care if you integrate or work or whatever. I don't care if I'm a racist. So be it. It's our land.
No racists on our streets.
No racists on our streets. No racists on our streets. No racists on our streets. No racists on our streets. No racists on our streets. No racists on our streets. No racists on our streets.
Wait, what the fuck is that all about? And then, in the original video you'd see the colonists killing off the Native American tribes, riveting. 4 years later.
I am educated. I have been at the university, and I have a master in community relations and Indian privilege.
Nice little dog whistle there, my friend.
I have learned that all the major positions in all of the tribes are Native Americans. Not a single is white. That is a clear evidence of discrimination and racism.
Why does Cockahannis sound like Elizabeth Warren? Is this supposed to reference her tiny Native American ancestry? No, of course not. This video was originally made in 2012. Donald Trump wasn't running for president at that time, so the joke wasn't made yet.
Whites are being held down by the racist Indians and must fight to take their rightful place in society.
We must replace the Indian chiefs with white people, since skin color doesn't matter.
I can't think of a comment more ironic than that.
You were right. It is very hard to see racism when you are Indian.
Of course! We are all humans.
I started an anti-racist movement to fight racism. I located all the racist hate groups, and all of them are in this book.
Wonderful! This is great!
Are you fucking kidding me? Indian Defense League? You can't even spell league correctly. Man, for such defenders of glorious white culture, you can't even go back to where you left off and at least correct your spelling mistake. Jesus Christ, this is so embarrassing. Shit.
I'm not anti-Indian, I'm anti-racist.
Over the years, the hateful and intolerant North American Indians continually tried to selflessly hoard their land and resources from the white refugees in need. I like how the person who uploaded the version of the video I am commentating on tries to keep the race category labels formal and PC, when the original maker of the video would probably applaud the genocide and subjugation of the Native Americans during that time.
What is going on here?
Holy hell, the animation looks a lot worse than the previous one. I mean, look at this. Say what you want about the last one and the very minimal animation it possessed, but at least it didn't look like shit. The fluent animation is alright, but goddammit, this looks awful. It looks like it was taken straight out of Jimmy Screamer Claus's movies.
How did the whites get all this housing?
Indians give it to them.
Why?
They say not to do so would be a violation of their human rights.
What? This is insane!
I mean, they could have rounded up the white people, having them stand against the wall and shooting them in the back of the head, but giving them housing? No, that's just too much.
Hello, Chief Strongwinds.
What on earth is going on here?
What do you mean?
All of these immigrants are getting free teepees and food.
So apparently, television was a thing back in the early 1600s. You know, I shouldn't be all that surprised given how much shit I've been exposed to so far in this video.
Yes, of course. We are refugees fleeing Europe.
What does that have to do with us giving you free housing and food?
Chief Strongwinds, you of all Indians should know, we're all equal, so we should all have equal access to housing and food.
I mean, unless, if you didn't have currency in your tribe, I think it can only be just, if they actually paid for the same amount of money the Native Americans do, if we truly wanted to achieve real equality. But, I don't even see how the same can be applied to the real world.
Why should illegal white immigrants get free access to our housing and our food?
Because currency wasn't all that viable to the native tribes at the seams, so...
Because we whites are human, just like you. And we are not illegal. No human can be illegal. We are just economic refugees seeking opportunity.
You are not just like us.
So you're saying that we whites are not human?
I am pretty certain that Rudolph the Tall White Indian would probably concur and try to justify your hypothesis right there.
No, no. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that you are white and we are Indians.
How can you be so racist? You are an embarrassment to Indians.
I still can't get over the horrendous looking animation. Why does the Indian in the left look like a painted pulpit? I mean, holy hell.
If we Indians have equal access to housing and food, we must extend this equal access to the whites as well.
Exactly. Wait, is the argument that the whites are getting everything for free, and the rest of the Indians have to pay money for the stuff they buy, and the person in the left insists that it's equality? It's not equality when you're just giving minorities free stuff, while the rest have to pay for them. I could somewhat agree with the narrative that that's not fair, if this actually happens in real life, which I've yet to see.
Anything other than that would be a violation of their human rights.
We Indians have not voted on these policies.
Oh God! It is 1613 and everyone on Earth knows that basic human rights are not subject to a vote.
Well, everyone who is not a racist already knows that.
You know, just from that bit, I am guessing that the person who made this wants men rights to have less rights than the dominant white culture.
Well, I am no racist. Out of curiosity, what are all these whites going to do once they are comfortable in their teepees?
Oh, Chief! We are busy doing the jobs Indians don't want to do. And we are making huge, valuable contributions to your society. Allow me to show you. You see, Chief? We are doing the jobs Indians won't do.
Wait. I thought that the stereotype was that immigrants were just a bunch of freeloaders leeching off of the system, not doing any valuable work for the community they are leeching off of. Now we are seeing them actually doing something useful for the community. I don't think the writer even knows what the narrative is supposed to be. It went from immigrants are a bunch of freeloaders, and then you show them providing something new to the table, therefore disproving your entire hypothesis. I am starting to believe that you don't have any reasonable arguments against immigration, but rather anger-filled vitriolic takes against the aesthetic of the very idea of immigration that revolves around what many would call the American dream.
Wait just a minute. This village used to house all Indians. All these jobs used to be done by Indians. How did this happen so quickly?
You know, I am of the opinion that, unless, if you're not going to provide anything good for the country, like terrorists or criminals, I don't really see a problem with immigration at all, just as long as you work, pay taxes and live a happy life, and respect the people that are already living in said country. The person who made this video, White Rabbit Radio, doesn't seem to care about any of that at all. All the person seemingly cares about is mother white ethnostate and mother white babies. These people are white supremacists, so it's understandable for them not to expect anything good coming from immigration.
When the whites moved in, we called an election, and the whites voted themselves in charge of the village.
What? You allowed all these whites to vote in Indian elections?
Oh no, how dare you get people who legally came to the country to vote in our elections? How terrible must that be for society? By the way, most of the immigrants that came to the country come from socially conservative backgrounds, so I think this could be a good voting bloc for conservatives in the long run.
We had to give them equal access to the political process. We did not want to violate their human rights.
And according to the person who made this video, all of these things are all bad.
Our Indian neighbors have embraced diversity and multiculturalism. They could have been evil neo-Nazi fascists.
And by multicultural, you mean multiracial, and unfortunately Native American and European Caucasian technically doesn't constitute for multiracialism, but biracialism. I'm sorry.
Chief Strongwinds, you won't succumb to racism and hate, will you?
So let me understand this. The white immigrants keep coming. We give them housing, food, and equal access to the political process. They in turn vote and take over everything. We cannot deny the whites any of these things because that would violate their human rights. We Indians cannot vote on any of these policies because basic human rights cannot be subject to voting. And if I disagree with this policy, I am a racist and full of hate?
Well, if you don't want immigrants to have the same voting rights as the native population, which for some reason translates to only the immigrants voting according to the creator of the video, but whatever, then yes, you are kind of racist. Also, I notice that the chief, who is someone that the creator of the video is supposed to have us agree with, is not providing any actual arguments against the idea of immigration. It would make a lot of sense when you are a white nationalist. It's pretty hard to have a person who is not white to provide any arguments, because you believe that white people are superior to all others, and unfortunately this is one instance where they should use the natives to spew out their ideas, but they don't, because that would first require them to put down the idea of white supremacy inspired by seething, foaming of the mouth hatred for everyone else, which is unfortunately something that their brain is unable to do. If I am not confident in them doing it, why would I take whatever they say as face value? What if the refugee crisis is not setting in motion for white genocide?
Yes!
Chief Strongwinds, I sense some resistance. You're not secretly a racist or some kind of neo-Nazi, are you?
No, no, of course I am not a racist neo-Nazi.
Fantastic! Equality, here we come. Chief, we are setting out on this wonderful voyage together. We are going to sail across the seas of multiculturalism. And the wind in our sails will be diversity.
According to the person who made this video, all the officials in Western civilization only care about diversity, nothing more. This is what happens when you are a fascist. You maximize your leader's idea of your nation being multicultural above every other issue they care about. The European Union wanted a pan-European army to secure EU borders, as well as fight in international conflicts like fighting terrorists. What's that about open border policies again? Fuck you, White Rabbit Radio. And this is where I am ending the video. Overall, the video was trash. Don't get me wrong, I do believe that there are some consequences with immigration, and that's because I want the best to come from these people. Unfortunately, once again, that's not why White Rabbit Radio made this video. His only concern for immigration is not whether or not there are going to be criminals crossing the border. All he cares about is whether or not he's going to have his precious white ethnos state in the United States. The fact that he used Native Americans as a cloak to spew out the need for such thing is pretty disgusting, since white people were the same people that wiped them out long ago, and the alt-right is insisting that they should form an ethno-state on a continent they stole from the natives. These white nationalists would have applauded for the deportation, subjugation, and systematic genocide against natives, and they have the nerve to say that they are the victims of the same thing, through what? A few brown people doing bad stuff? Really? This is how neo-Nazis bring people to their group. They gather hopeless young white men into their group through fear that they will be going away, and the only way they can survive is through mass deportation of the people who already came here legally anyway. Anyone who has those types of ideas are not to be trusted, and the people who has delved deep enough in right-wing circles would know what I am talking about. They call themselves either white nationalists, identitarians, anti-globalism or whatever, but the truth of the matter is that they have the same type of thinking as the Nazis did back in the 30s. This should serve as a hard lesson to not trust everything you hear online, kids. Anyway, this is Ottomagic Critic, and make sure you hit the big, fat, dislike button below the video. Report the video for hate speech so that my video will be taken down. See you next time.